stand, please. Friends, we've come today to join Jarod and Candice in marriage. This ceremony is taking place because they want you and God to be witnesses of their commitment to one another. This commitment is a sacred covenant. It was ordained by God at the very beginning of creation. And the Apostle Paul said that it should not be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but soberly, discreetly, reverently, and in the fear of God. This is the spirit that Jarod and Candice bring to this ceremony today. You may have a seat if you
The moment that each of you asked Jesus into your heart, you entered into a relationship with him. And for that relationship to grow, there has to be three things present. One is a desire to know Jesus each and every day as best as you can. A willingness to put him first in everything that you do. And a need to communicate, to speak, to listen, and to understand. And yes, it's okay to ask God why when we don't understand. I want you to realize that marriage, at its heart, is more than a legal contract. It is a lifetime relationship, a relationship that also will require three things. Desire. A desire to choose one another each and every day. A willingness to put his needs, a willingness to put her needs before your own. And a need to communicate, to speak, to listen, and to understand. If these things are present, your relationship will grow, it will strengthen, and it will enable you to face together whatever life brings your way. Let us pray. Father God, we come to you in the name of Jesus to ask your blessing over Jarod and Candice. Father, we ask that you would just put a hedge of angels around them to protect them. And Father, each day that they arise and take breath, I pray that they will take one step closer to you and one step closer to each other. Father, we ask your blessing upon this marriage. In Jesus' name, amen.
Mess all this up, or we can just keep going. Okay, all right. Jarod, do you take Candice, whose hand you now hold, to be your wife, to live together following God's holy laws in marriage? And will you fulfill your obligation as her husband to love her, honor her, protect her, and cherish her? And will you be faithful to her in all aspects of your life together? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
And Candice, do you take Jarod, whose hand you now hold, to be your husband, to live together following God's holy laws in marriage? Will you fulfill your obligation as his wife to love him, honor him, protect him, and cherish him? And will you be faithful to him in all aspects of your life together? If so, say, I do. I would appreciate a little more conviction. Yes, I mean, it's good. I understand, but just a little more.
You will.
All right. Okay. Jarod, repeat after me. To her. I, Jarod.
I, Jarod.
Take you, Candice.
Take you, Candice.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
And I promise before God.
I promise before God.
Our family and friends.
Our family and friends.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
I will rejoice with you in times of success.
I will rejoice with you in times of success.
And comfort you in times of disappointment.
And comfort you in times of disappointment.
As your husband.
As your husband.
I will share all that I am.
I will share all that I am.
And all that I have with you.
And all that I have with you.
I will forgive you.
I will forgive you.
As Christ has forgiven me.
As Christ has forgiven me.
And I will remind you of the Lord's plans.
And I will remind you of the Lord's plans.
And promises for this marriage.
And promises for this marriage.
I devote my love.
I devote my love.
And my life to you.
And my life to you.
From this day until our days are ended.
From this day until our days are ended.
Well, he did well.
It's Jarod.
I know. I know. I'm just putting a little more pressure on you. That's all. Repeat after me. I, Candice.
I, Candice.
Take you, Jarod.
Take you, Jarod.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
And I promise before God.
And I promise before God.
Our family and friends.
Our family and friends.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
I will rejoice with you.
I will rejoice with you.
In times of success.
In times of success.
And comfort you.
And comfort you.
In times of disappointment.
In times of disappointment.
As your wife.
As your wife.
I will share all I am.
I will share all that I am.
And all that I have with you.
And all that I have with you, like the kitten.
You just had to sneak that one in, huh? All right. Did you know about that one?
That was a surprise.
Okay, all right. Just checking. Just
like
checking.
You said yes.
Now, to go along with that, I will forgive you.
I will forgive you.
As Christ has forgiven me.
Christ has forgiven me.
And I will remind you.
And I will remind you.
Of the Lord's plans.
And
promises for this marriage.
For our marriage.
I devote my love.
I devote my love.
And my life to you.
From this day.
Until our days are ended.
Until our days are ended.
So Jarod, what gift do you give to Candice?
A ring.
Besides a kitten.
Oh. One ring.
All right.
I gave that to him.
Okay. All right. And Candice, what gift do you give to Jarod?
A ring. Okay. And a kitten.
And a kitten. Would you pray with me? Father, these rings are precious because humanity has assigned value to them. But they are so much more. They are a representation of this moment together. They're a representation of the promises that are made. And that makes them priceless. So I pray for Jarod and Candice as they wear these rings, as they are reminded each moment of these promises made. And I pray that you will bless the rings and those who wear them. This is my prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen. Take that one. Put it on her finger. Repeat after me. This ring is a symbol.
This ring is a symbol.
Of my love and faithfulness.
Of my love and faithfulness.
I give it to you.
I give it to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Repeat after me. He's got the right one. Yeah. This ring is a symbol.
This ring is a symbol.
Of my love and faithfulness.
My love and faithfulness.
I give it to you.
I give it to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
Of the Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
So we have invited the Holy Spirit to bless this wedding and make it acceptable in the eyes of God. So if you'll just give us a moment, we're going to sign a few papers to make it acceptable in Indiana. So.
Thank you.
So just to the bridal party for a moment. So you, you're honored to be an important part of Jarod and Candice's life. And that's why you're standing in the spot where you are right now, because they treasure you. Your responsibilities don't end here today. So will you support them in this marriage? Will you encourage them and hold them accountable to the promises that they have made today? If so, say we will.
Sure. You want to try again, Tab?
More non-committal. All right, good. All right, good. And by the way, you all as well are witnesses to the promises and vows spoken by Jarod and Candice. Do you promise to love them and support them and encourage them? Will you, as this congregation, be on their side as they walk together in this life as husband and wife? If so, say we will. Great. We've done all those things now. Now you just have to put up with figuring out what I'm going to say. I'm going to start with just a quick passage of scripture out of Ecclesiastes. Two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, they can help each other up. But pity the one who falls down and has no one to help him up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. And a cord of three strands is not easily broken. So I just have a couple of observations and then a challenge for you as well. I told you I was going to start this way. Yeah, you two aren't normal. That may not seem like a compliment, but actually, it's quite awesome, I think. You're a unique combination of overstructured and unstructured. An unusual mix of planned and unpredictable. It's annoying and adorable at the same time. Yeah, I think so. You two are willing to face all of that together. So I have no doubt because of that, that the two of you actually love each other and are committed to this marriage. You're both gonna, but the good thing is that you know what you're getting when you're walking into it, right? So listen to me for just a moment. Ecclesiastes talks about this cord that's woven together. It says that two are better than one. And that's especially true when one cord has a weak point or a frayed edge or something along that lines, right? And both of you have those, by the way. We all do. So we all have those weak points. We all come with scars from other relationships. We all have personality flaws and quirks. We have areas of strengths and areas of weaknesses. And sometimes it's hard to tell the difference, right? Is spontaneity a strength or a weakness? What about organization? Is that a strength or a weakness? You each know the strengths and weaknesses in your lives. But this is what I know. You two are creating this stronger cord by joining together. You choose to see the differences in the other person as a way to complement who you are as individuals. Is it easy? Nope. Jarod, she is going to mess up your world. And she's going to make you redecorate. And she's bringing a kitten.
The kitten.
The kitten. All right, the kitten. Candice, he is going to see, he's going to get you to see the joy of calendars and spreadsheets and data, all kinds of things. It's his goal, right? And he's going to make you dinner when you spontaneously want to go out. It's just going to happen. You two are in for a lot of adjustments and a lot of great conversations. You two can handle all of these as long as you stay connected, intertwined as one cord. I know you can do this, and I'll tell you why I know. Because, for one thing, I can't look at him and the way he looks at you without being completely convinced that he is madly and deeply in love with you. You just see it. He really loves you. You can't miss it. And it's clear also that Candice loves you. So much that she wants to share the joy and the laughter that comes with her life. And that's good. That is good. So now for the challenge. The scripture in Ecclesiastes starts talking with a strand of two chords. But then all of a sudden it switches at the last minute to a strand of three. And Jeff talked about this, right? A chord of three strands is not easily broken. We have had enough conversations for you to know that the third chord is Jesus. You're in this church today because you're inviting the Holy Spirit to be a part of this ceremony and a part of your lives. You can't stop there. That's not his plan. Jesus wants you to invite him to be a part of your marriage, not just your wedding. As you move forward, you choose if that happens. It's a daily choice that you make. You both know what it looks like when you try to live life with him as opposed to life without him. So choose with him. His desire is to be the third chord that makes your relationship unbreakable, unstoppable. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? You choose each other. So do you choose Jesus? That's the question. Okay? That was all right, wasn't it?
It was good.
Okay, good. Listen, because Jarod and Candice have both agreed to this marriage, and because they avowed their love and loyalty before God and you, their family and friends, and because they have given evidence of their marriage by the exchange of rings, it is with joy that I, by the authority committed to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, declare that Jarod and Candice are now husband and wife in the eyes of the God and in the laws of the state of Indiana. What God has joined together, let no one try to tear apart. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. All right, are you ready? Are you ready?
1 to 5?
Yeah, don't back away. All right, Jarod, kiss your bride. It is a privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jarod Arford. They forgot you. They forgot you. You just go on down.